Hello, Mary Me. So, I want to review a book. The book I want to review is this one. Hermetic Astrology by Oliver St. John. This is a book that, while it says hermetic, it is definitely based in the Thelema tradition of Aleister Crowley, which is based on Western esotericism. And a little smudging of Eastern one as well. And it's based a lot around hermetic ideas, so the title isn't wrong. But just so we are clear that this is mainly focused on the Thelema system and not on general flavor hermeticism. So that is so. Another caveat I should do before I begin this review is that astrology is not something I'm good at. I know a little bit about it, but it's not one of the areas within the occult that I have spent a lot of time. And it's also one of those things that, you know, planetary hours, planetary days, these can be extremely helpful in magic, absolutely. However, as somebody who suffers from depression, very often I have to do my workings when I have the energy and ability to do them, and not at whatever hour the stars say. So, and I was stuck for a very long time, not moving forward, because I was so hung up on the idea that I had to get the planetary hours and days right, that I sort of lost myself in that. And when I got past that, I've sort of ended up with a little bit of a block when it comes to that whole thing. But it's time to do something about that, because the way I look at it is that when I have the strength and energy to work with these energies, that is great, and I can benefit from that extra energy. And when I don't, I can do my rituals when I have the energy. So I should definitely learn more about it. So I have not a huge background in astrology, not as a ritual tool and not as a divination tool. So yeah, this book is definitely meant for people that have a lot more experience in astrology than I do, but I still understood it. And I think that one of the definitions I would have of a good non-fiction book is one where I know more about the topic when I put the book down after I read it than I did before. And I definitely did with this. I felt I learned a lot about astrology used within ritual from this book. And that alone makes it worth the read. So, let's have a look-see. We have a preface, which is pretty self-explanatory. We have an introduction, which also is pretty explanatory. We have a diagram of the Tree of Life. We have the Kabbalistic key to the Tarot and the Zodiac diagram, which basically it basically puts the Zodiac in the context of the Tree of Life. And then we have Know Thyself, and then we have the geocentric framework, which is also a diagram. And we have Know Thyself, which basically says how doing an astrological reading and also adding the points that this book discusses can help you develop as you will get a greater understanding of yourself. Then you have Refined Die, Rapture, Heart of Fortune, the Starry Dragon, and Lucifer Rising, which are all aspects that a regular astrologer might not add. Basically what this book do is that it has some aspects that regular astrology doesn't, which has all to do with which stars are in so-and-so degree to one another, and so on and so forth. I have limited use of that since I don't know how to do a chart in the first place. I can use a program to do it, but I can't do it by hand. Though it is definitely an interesting read. Definitely, if I were going to do a chart and sit with the guidebooks and struggle through it, I would add these things. But it also goes more into how to use it for a chore. We have aspects, more of that. Descendant and the Ka double, Alt the Gateways, the Natal Shard Master Key, and the Creator Cup, Astrological Time Factors, and Tarot and Astrology. Pretty self-explanatory. So basically what it does is it goes through ways to use astrology as a ritual tool by timing your ritual with astrology and also getting a greater feel about what the challenges for our working will be, and so on and so forth. You can say that you birth the magic at the time you do it, so you can do a chart for it. So you can do for any endeavor. It goes through these additions to these hermetic additions to a chart, which has more to do with the spirituality, magic, and spiritual self-development than a lot of the regular ones. And it's quite interesting. And it also goes through a lot of sample charts for famous Thelemites and other magicians, and sees how these various aspects are reflected within their chart. It's not a very big book, and there's a lot of these charts in here. So it's a pretty quick read. I think I used a couple of hours on it. But there's a lot of good information in here. And I think that somebody who is more experienced with astrology will get even more out of it than I did. So yeah, I really like this book. I felt that I learned more about both regular astrology and the hermetic flavor of it from reading this book. Though I did definitely feel that I was not the intended or audience, since I don't have the background in astrology, this assumes that you do. So keep that in mind, though I still learned quite a bit from it. So yeah, it's well written. It is interesting. You have a lot of showing these principles in practice, which aids learning. And yeah, so just be aware that it is definitely geared toward Thelemites, and it's geared toward those with experience in astrology. But I also think that people that has never used astrology within their practice can learn something from this book, just not as much as if you have a greater background in it. So yeah, I really like it. I'll give it 9 out of 10. And that is my review of Hermetic Astrology by Oliver St. John. I think this is self-published. I'm not completely sure. Let me check. It doesn't. No, it is one. It's Ordo Astri Imperitur is the one that has apparently published this. And here are the other books by this author. And I think I will have to get them because I like this one. Yay, more books. So yeah, that was my review. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Have a great day and blessed be.